Almost every major airport faces controller furloughs, but dozens of small to medium-sized airports could be forced to close completely their control towers. So what does this mean for us here in South Florida? Let's go to Randy Gyllenhaal, who's live now to explain. Randy?
Yeah, Tiffany, like you said, this will affect everyday travelers at some of the bigger commercial hubs, but the main impact will be at smaller airports where air traffic control towers could be cut and real jobs could be completely lost.
Left or right traffic is approved for Charlie Golf.
For the past 4 years, air traffic controller Len Knight has been guiding planes into the Boca Raton Airport.
Let's cross runway 23.
It's just after noon, and he's talking to the pilot of a corporate jet from Canada about to land.
Runway 23, clear to land.
This happens about 500 times a day, but starting in April, the tower might close. Len would be out of a job, and pilots would have to make their final approach solo.
The day that came out, we were all equally surprised.
Tower manager David Bazanis says a shutdown would be devastating. At least 7 employees could lose their jobs.
We're waiting every day to get additional information with everyone else to see what our fate's going to be over the next few weeks.
The FAA hasn't told them much, but this tower, along with hundreds of others across the country, are on the chopping block, a consequence of the sequester unless Congress finds a way to act. A majority of takeoffs and landings here are private jets, mostly business executives who live or work near Boca.
Unfortunately, that's one of the impacts that would be felt if this tower were to be closed. Many of the corporate jet operators are not allowed to operate into fields that don't have an operating control tower.
But everyday taxpayers also take a hit. In the past few years, $2 million has been invested into this tower, wasted if it closes down.
Hey, Miami, Boca Airlines, G-Scope.
For now, controllers just keep working. That jet from Canada landed safely as the congressional clock keeps ticking.
That's basically what we've been told. We have to wait and see, just like everybody else.
Well, if these employees do get laid off, it could even be more difficult for them to get a new job. That's because the sequester would also cut millions of dollars in funding going towards job search programs in Florida, meaning almost 100,000 unemployed people could lose access to job search programs. Congress has 3 days. For now, we're live in the newsroom. Randy Gyllenhaal, WPBF 25.